For spacious skies, for amber waves of grain, for purple mountain majesties above the fruited plain. America, God shed his grace on thee and crown thy good with brotherhood from sea to shining sea. For heroes proved in liberating strife, who more than self their country loved, and mercy more than life. Amen. America, may God thy gold refine, till all success be nobleness, and every gain divine.
Good afternoon. Please be seated. I am Dr. Dan Meir, President of the Cardinal Stritch University Faculty Council. I am privileged to serve as a biology professor and the chair of Sciences and Math Department, and I'm a proud member of the Stritch Class of 1989. It is my honor to welcome you to the Cardinal Stritch University College of Undergraduate Studies commencement ceremony. Please join me in a round of applause for Mark Quistorf, who sang America the Beautiful. Mark serves as the university's Director of Financial Aid and is a 2007 Stritch graduate. Allow me to begin this afternoon's ceremony by introducing members of the platform party. I ask that the following groups and individuals please stand. Sister Angeline Dries, a member of the Sisters of St. Francis of Assisi, our founders and sponsors, and a member of the University Board of Trustees. Additional members of the University Board of Trustees. Ms. Thelma A. Sias, a member of the University Board of Trustees and today's keynote speaker. The university's vice presidents, the deans and associate deans of the College of Undergraduate Studies, the Ruth S. Coleman College of Nursing and Health Sciences, and the College of Graduate Studies, Ms. Sherry Tussler, honorary degree recipient, Michaela Fonseca, our student speaker, who received a Bachelor of Arts degrees in Sociology and Spanish in 2020. Emily Chepleski, the class of 2021 valedictorian and a Bachelor of Arts degree candidate who will lead us in the invocation. Professor Marilyn Jones, chair of the Humanities Department and recipient of the 2020 Stritch Presidential Award for Civic Action and Engagement, who will lead our benediction at the end of the ceremony. And Dr. Daniel J. Scholes, Cardinal Stritch University Interim President. The banners carried during the procession today are called gonfalons. The platform party can return to their seats. They have had special significance in formal ceremonies since the medieval period, especially in Italy during the time of St. Clair and St. Francis of Assisi. The gonfalons include our university seal, as well as the founding year and regalia colors of each college. There is also a gonfalon representing the more than 38,000 Stritch alumni. Your graduation from Cardinal Stritch University is truly an exciting and important occasion. It is a time for reflection, as well as a time to look forward to the future. We celebrate all of the students, faculty, and staff who have preceded us. Their dedication to excellence and embrace of the Franciscan values that define Stritch and have led us to this very special moment in our history. And we celebrate all of you, our graduates, who have worked so hard to reach this milestone and are now ready to engage in a new chapter of opportunity and achievement. We begin our program with the invocation led by Emily Chepleski, a Bachelor of Arts candidate and Class of 2021 valedictorian. Please stand.
Let us pause for a moment and recognize the sacred presence of God in our midst. God of wisdom and truth, we come before you today grateful for the accomplishments that we celebrate and mindful that they were not accomplished alone. Therefore, we ask you to bless our university community, the families that have come here to celebrate, and especially our graduates. May they be inspired by the community of saints that we memorialize on our campus. Inspired by St. Bonaventure for his lifelong search for truth and beauty. Inspired by Roger Bacon for his curiosity and ingenuity, which led to the modern scientific method. Inspired by Blessed John Duns Scotus for his keen intellect and humble spirit. And inspired by Saints Francis and Claire for their commitment to the gospel values of loving God and loving neighbor. We thank you for the heart to live lives of compassion, the hands to reach out and create communities rooted in caring for one another, the eyes to see the beauty in all creation and to recognize your divine presence, the mind to understand that our differences make us stronger, enabling us to build peace together. We pray all of these things with confidence in your profound love for us. Amen.
Sister Angeline Dries, a member of the Sisters of St. Francis of Assisi, and a member of the university's Board of Trustees, will join Dr. Mary Kellner and Mr. Gerard Randall, co-chairs of the Board of Trustees, in a special candle lighting ceremony. This ceremony proclaims and affirms our Catholic Franciscan identity and gives special recognition to the saint for whom the university was first named in 1937, St. Clare of Assisi. St. Clare, along with the better known St. Francis of Assisi, was a co-founder of the Franciscan tradition. Her name, Clare, means light or bright. This lighting of the Clare candle reminds us of all of the university's commitment to be a light to our world, bringing the Franciscan values of making peace, showing compassion, creating a caring community, and reverencing all creation. May we, in turn, live these values as members and graduates of the Stritch community, bringing our light to the world. Thank you, Sister Angeline, Dr. Kellner, and Mr. Randall. It is now my honor and pleasure to introduce the interim president of Cardinal Stritch University, Dr. Dan Scholes. Dr. Scholes has served at Cardinal Stritch University for 17 years. He was named interim president in August 2020. In addition to his role as interim president, he is the university's vice president of academic affairs. During his time at Stritch, Dr. Scholes has demonstrated his commitment to the university's Catholic Franciscan identity and to the success of our students. Welcome, Dr. Scholes.
Thank you, Dr. Muir. Please be seated. Welcome to members of the Cardinal Stritch University classes of 2020 and 2021. Will members of the platform party and our guests please join me in a well-deserved round of applause for these exceptional candidates and graduates. Will everyone also join me in thanking our partners here at Panther Arena for creating a safe environment today so we could gather and celebrate the achievements and the accomplishments of our graduates and our candidates. Today's ceremonies are a sign that we are slowly but surely beginning to return to life as we knew it before the COVID pandemic. And I can think of no better way to celebrate than commencement to show we are on the road to recovery. I would like to acknowledge and thank our founders and sponsors, the Sisters of St. Francis of Assisi, who opened St. Clair College in 1937. Their extraordinary vision, commitment, sacrifice, and leadership continue to shape our university. The sisters have served as faculty, staff members, administrators, and presidents at Stritch, and they pray for our well-being each day. I know they join us in celebrating the accomplishments of our candidates and graduates. I would also like to recognize the members of the University Board of Trustees who have joined us today. We are fortunate to be guided by these women and men who are dedicated to ensuring the Stritch legacy continues for years and years to come. I would like to call everyone's attention to the flags of international countries displayed on the arena floor just to my left. These flags represent the various countries that our students, our Stritch students, call home. We are very proud of the rich diversity of our Stritch family, and know that our university has a global impact through the thousands of students who have chosen Stritch for their educational journey. I've been a member of the Stritch family for 17 years, and commencement is always one of the highlights of the academic year. This year's celebration certainly will have a special place in Stritch history. Not only are we recognizing your outstanding achievement, we are recognizing your tremendous resilience and dedication. I would like to ask the class members of 2020 to stand so we can recognize them. We all know the ending to your Stritch career was not what you expected or wanted. Neither did we. However, the global pandemic did not diminish all you accomplished. And while the celebration of your achievement has been delayed by a year, I am so grateful that you are joining us today. Thank you. You may be seated. Candidates and graduates, your Stritch education has prepared you for success in the communities where you will live, work, serve, and lead. Through Stritch's rigorous academic programs, you have gained the necessary knowledge, skills, and dispositions to begin your chosen career. Your Stritch experience, particularly over the last 2 years, has affirmed that you can successfully face any challenge that comes your way. The Franciscan values of creating a caring community, making peace, showing compassion, and reverencing all of creation influence every aspect of life at Stritch and has been an essential part of your education from the first day you came on campus to this day. These values are now embedded within you and will serve as a beacon professionally and personally as you move on from Stritch. This special moment allows us to focus on what our lives should be grounded in. We've been living in an extraordinarily stressful times, dealing with complex and unforeseen crises over the past year. The coronavirus pandemic, widespread economic disruption, the scourge of racial injustice, and political upheaval and conflict. As members of the Stritch family, we are called to be engaged in life and society, spiritually, philosophically, and pragmatically. And as we sift through the complexities that life presents to us, or when we struggle with doubt, or uncertain about what action to take, we can always look to the commandments to love God and to love your neighbor as yourself. We must continue to have faith in the Lord, in ourselves, and in each other, and be the solution to the many challenges that face us, as well as those that lie ahead of us. Candidates and graduates, please take a moment to acknowledge the family and friends, those gathered with us today, and those watching us online, who have provided unwavering support every step of the way along your journey. You may applause. In addition to family and friends, members of the Stritch faculty have been essential in the success of our candidates and graduates and serve as a great source of pride for the entire Stritch family. I ask that the members of the faculty please rise so we can recognize your dedication and contributions to our students and the university. In addition to our faculty, Stritch staff members have devoted countless hours to ensure that all of our graduates receive the support necessary to arrive at this milestone today. We are very grateful for the extraordinary work of these men and women, especially those who have worked tirelessly to make today so special for us. Candidates and graduates, I would like to conclude my remarks with a simple yet heartfelt thank you. I'm so grateful that you chose Cardinal Stritch University to be part of your journey. Your Stritch experience has prepared you for the next chapter in your lives. You have my prayers and best wishes. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Scholes, for your remarks and for your outstanding leadership and commitment to our university. Today's student speaker is Micaela Fonseca, who received a bachelor's degree in sociology and Spanish in 2020. Micaela spent her time at Stritch immersing herself in the university's community. She was president of Dreamers Welcome and was a Student Government Association senator. Micaela also served as a resident hall assistant and was an active member of Franciscan Servant Scholars and the Leaders Program. She used these experiences to connect with students, faculty, and staff and enrich her Stritch experience. She is now a teacher at Carmen Middle School South in Milwaukee, where she continues her commitment to building community. I am pleased and honored to introduce to you Micaela Fonseca.
Hello. Fellow graduates, my Stritch community, and all of our loved ones, today is a very special day, to say the least. After the year that we've all had, it is so good to be surrounded by one another, celebrating each other's accomplishments, and feeling all there is to be felt now that we have reached the end. Some of us have spent the last year venturing into our own paths of adulthood, and some of us have been juggling the demands of online classes, in-person classes, jobs, families, life. You know the deal. Nonetheless, we all join together in community today to celebrate our victory, the triumph of making it to graduation day, despite what the last year has brought us, despite the challenges that have been thrown our way what seems like every other couple of weeks for the last couple of years, and despite each of the 100 times that we have all doubted our capabilities of finishing what we started the moment we decided to submit an application to be a student at Cardinal Stritch University. As a student at Cardinal Stritch University, we have all heard the infamous story of St. Francis of Assisi. For those of you who are unfamiliar with the story, I will give you a very brief summary. In the spring of 1206 in Assisi, Italy, Francesco Bernardone was a restless young man, unable to find his life's calling after being born into a life of wealth and privilege. He found himself wandering around the outskirts of his hometown of Assisi and came upon San Damiano, a small rundown church. He went inside and knelt down underneath a large wooden crucifix, looking up to the figure of Jesus. "Lord," he said, "what do you want me to do? Show me what you want me to do with my life." "Francis," a voice responded, calling him by name, "go rebuild my house. As you see, it is all being destroyed." And with that, St. Francis of Assisi went on to rebuild the small rundown church, only to realize after the deed was done that the calling that had found its way to him was much more than just rebuilding the church he had set foot in. He went on, back to the people, back to the community, and purely demonstrated the four Franciscan values that we uphold within the Stritch community. To make peace, create a caring community, show compassion, and to reverence all of creation. I first heard this story during my first semester at Stritch back in the fall of 2016, a long time ago. I was taking a seminar, Leadership for Change, led by our very own Dr. Kate Might. And Sean Lansing was presenting to us this story and doing so with so much love and admiration, it was difficult to not share his feelings about this history. Of the entire time that we spent with him, I remember four words in particular. Four words that I carry with me into each space that I enter and into each chapter that I walk into. Root all with love. I remember hearing him speak those words as he referenced the story of St. Francis and thinking to myself, what? What does love have to do with rebuilding a church? And what does love have to do with St. Francis finding his life's calling as spoken to him by Jesus? And as I sat there, having one of those moments where your entire perspective of life shifts and suddenly you realize that really the only thing that matters in life is love and kindness, and having compassion for yourself and others, I began to come to a sense of understanding that truly barely scratches the surface of what it means to be a member of the Stritch community. Regardless of your major, regardless of how many years you were a student here, no matter what beautiful differences set us all apart from one another, we all share this wonderful experience of being in this community together. We know what it's like to walk through the halls and wave hello to basically everyone you walk past because you know everyone here. We understand the feeling of walking into your favorite professor's class and knowing that they see you as more than just a student. They take the time to hold space for you when you feel like you have no idea what you're doing, which happens a lot, right? This looks like Dr. Amber Tucker staying on the phone for an hour with me last May and reminding myself of my capabilities while I try to convince both her and myself that I was going to drop out of my senior seminar. I stayed and I powered through because of her. This looks like me practically sobbing, which I was, in front of the entire class as I presented a very personal project in my Narratives of Immigrant Spanish class. I look over to Marilyn Jones and she reminds me to breathe and to tie a knot in my stomach and to be brave. I finish my presentation and I now look back on that memory every time I have to do something terrifying. We have all experienced a moment such as these. Our professors and the people that we meet in this wonderful community are there alongside you with everyone else who loves you, rooting for you on the sidelines as you work to create and find your own life path and calling. Everything we experienced here was, to say the least, rooted in love. Friends, today I congratulate each and every one of you on this magnificent accomplishment. Some of you, like me, are a first-generation college graduate, and you and your loved ones have been waiting for this day forever. Some of you have come from a long ways away and have created a home here at Stritch that you will soon be leaving behind. All of us, however, have pushed through this challenging year. To be here today, surrounded by people we love and by people who love us, who I also want to thank for supporting us every step of the way. I want to leave you all with a quote from my favorite childhood book, Ink Spell, by Cornelia Funke, that has been running around in my head for over a decade now. Stories never really end, even if the books like to pretend they do. Stories always go on. They don't end on the last page any more than they begin on the first page. Our chapter here, as an undergraduate student at Cardinal Stritch University, has come to its end. But onto the next page, we carry with us the love, compassion, and kindness that we have all experienced in creating this community together. As St. Francis was told, it is our time now to rebuild this house of ours and step into this world to do what we were meant to do. Root all with love. Thank you.
Thank you, Micaela, for your inspiring remarks and for having a lasting impact on our Stritch family. We now move to the presentation of the Doctor of Humane Letters honorary degree. The honorary degree, which is presented honoris causa, or for the sake of the honor, is awarded to recognize and celebrate an individual's significant contributions to society. We are very pleased and honored to present Ms. Sherry Tussler, Executive Director of the Hunger Task Force, with a Doctorate of Humane Letters. Ms. Tussler and Interim President Scholes, will you please come forward? Interim President Scholes, Sherry Tussler earned a Bachelor of Science degree in management from Cardinal Stritch University in 1997. In her role at Hunger Task Force, she oversees efforts in Wisconsin's fight against hunger. For close to 25 years, she has developed and implemented creative and innovative solutions to ending poverty. Ms. Tussler is committed to ensuring everyone's voice is heard and has centered the Hunger Task Force efforts around the values of justice, compassion, good stewardship, and dignity. Over the last year, during the COVID pandemic, the Hunger Task Force delivered emergency food supplies to organizations, schools, and institutions while continuing its service to seniors, low-income households, and children, providing free food for the hungry. Ms. Tussler has made significant contributions to society and to the well-being of our fellow citizens. Her work reflects the Franciscan values to which our university is dedicated. Ms. Tussler's achievements warrant special recognition by the university. Therefore, it is my honor and pleasure to recommend that Ms. Sherry Tussler be awarded a Doctor of Humane Letters, honoris causa, by Cardinal Stritch University this 16th day of May, 2021.
Thank you, Dr. Meir. Ms. Tussler, your dedication to our community is exceptional and inspires people throughout Wisconsin. You are the personification of a quote attributed to St. Francis of Assisi, "For it is in giving that we receive." We know that your work at the Hunger Task Force has been shaped in part by all that you learned and experienced during your time as an undergraduate student here at Stritch. We are so grateful to see you living the Franciscan values every day and as a result, enriching people's lives all across Wisconsin. The difference you are making not only has an impact today, but will have one for years and years to come. And so, by the authority invested in and delegated to me by the Cardinal Stritch University Board of Trustees, I am delighted and honored to confer on you the degree Doctor of Humane Letters, honoris causa. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in a round of applause for Dr. Sherry Tussler.
How awesome is this? Hello and congratulations to my fellow grads. I'm so very lucky and thankful to be here today. The people of Cardinal Stritch have understood me many times better than I understood my own talent and value. They've recognized my career work and today are gifting me a great honor. It's truly humbling. To begin, I must say that I have had only one honor greater than this gift today, and that is being the mother of two talented and educated young women. Madeline and Samantha, I love you very much. Congratulations to the classes of 2020 and 2021. Your successes during these challenging times are especially amazing. When offered a choice to be with the undergraduate or graduate commencement, I chose you. My daughters are both recent undergrads, and I can relate to your effort and ultimate success. For you 2020 grads, I know the pain of no ceremony, as my daughter Madeline graduated alone in Portland last year. She was at Lewis and Clark, and none of us were there to hug her. Today, accept my hug on top of that of your family and friends. 2020 grads, you have proved fierce. For you older undergrads, I just want to offer a giant cheer. Your efforts to finalize this journey have been hard fought, and being an adult student obviously complicates your ability like no other. And I get that because, like you, I made it across the finish line when I was 37 years old and 8 months pregnant. The Franciscan value that we celebrate this year is peace. While we all want peace, we also know that it's been hard fought. For me, there is no peace without justice. No peace, no justice was coined and has often been used to define the maltreatment of people of color during the attacks and ensuing protests this last year. The chant has been considered a threat by some, but for me, justice is inextricably linked to peace. This honor is given me today because as a Stritch grad, I earned employment both at a shelter for the houseless and at the Hunger Task Force, where I've worked for nearly 24 years. Madeline was a newborn when I began my journey as an advocate working to end hunger. Most of my successes at Hunger Task Force have occurred from risk-taking, calling out the elephant in the room, and refusing to sit down and silence myself when I was the minority in the room. As you seek employment or pursue advancement in your jobs, I encourage you to be that person with a voice. Work for justice to create peace. Poverty is the absence of money and is caused by social policies that at their worst create hunger and houselessness. Poverty is created by the wealthy. Poverty is not the lack of result of effort by the people that it harms, but poverty does kill, maim, and degrade people. It results in infant mortality, incarceration, poor health outcomes, wide-scale houselessness, and chronic hunger in our state and our nation. I want you to see poverty, address poverty, reject poverty, and ultimately fight poverty. To know peace, we must know justice. And fighting poverty does not mean giving me a can of soup with a job application rubber banded around it. It means electing people based on their interests in equity. It means showing up when the poor are at risk. It means reminding yourself every day of your privilege and what you are doing and what has been given to you. Cardinal Stritch has given much to you, and you may not realize the gifts of Franciscan values that you are gifted in this journey towards your degree, but they are here. As you walk through your family life, your career path, and your place in the community, know your values are embedded and let them speak to you as you make your decisions. Pursue equity at every opportunity. Look around, see and understand poverty. Continue to experience it through deprivation or charitable acts, and afterwards empower yourself through your voice and actions to end it. This has been my life's work, and it is truly satisfying. Congratulations to each of you for your achievements. You are amazing. Celebrate your accomplishments today and get busy making a difference as only you know how.
Congratulations, Dr. Tussler. Thank you for your inspiring remarks, your service, and your leadership. It is indeed an honor to recognize you as Dr. Tussler at Cardinal Stritch University. 16 distinguished individuals serve on the Cardinal Stritch University Board of Trustees. These accomplished men and women guide the university through their wisdom and expertise. We are honored to welcome Trustee Ms. Thelma A. Sias, who will deliver this morning's keynote address. Ms. Sias has served on the Stritch Board of Trustees since 2014. She was raised on a farm in Mayersville, Mississippi, by her parents, the late Roosevelt and Pauline Sias, and moved to Milwaukee in 1982. She has transformed our community through her leadership at We Energies for more than three decades, including her role as Vice President for Local Affairs and her service on the boards of many civic and community organizations. She is a tireless champion for our city and its people and has been recognized with numerous accolades. The Cardinal Stritch University family has been richly blessed as Ms. Sias's service, and we are thrilled that she will be addressing the classes of 2020 and 2021 today. Please help me welcome Ms. Thelma A. Sias for this afternoon's keynote address.
I would like to say good afternoon to everyone. I hope that you are feeling the excitement of this very special moment as grads, the class of 2020 and the class of 2021. I know you've been asked to stand and take actions again and again, but I'm going to ask your participation for a moment. I would like to ask all of the graduates to stand and look up in the stands around you at stand, that's the word, S-T-A-N-D, okay. I want you to look up in those stands and see all of the men and women, mothers and fathers, grandparents, aunts, uncles, sisters, brothers, husbands, wives, girlfriends, boyfriends, ex-girlfriends, ex-boyfriends. They're all here to cheer you on today. These are the men and women who believed in you. These are the people that invested in you. These are the people that gave you the 20 to put the gas in your car the last time you had to come to campus. These are the men and women who saw your potentials and have joined with you to celebrate today. I want you to give them a round of applause. I can't hear you. I can't hear you. I can't hear you. I can't hear you. Raise the roof. Thank you very much. You may be seated. I have the honor today to spend some time with you and share some thoughts on this moment as you celebrate this accomplishment. And what I want to talk to you about very seriously is the moment in time in which you are in, the moment in time in which each of us have experienced over the past year, the moment in time in which men and women names you don't know, and faces you've never seen, how they have become common words in all of the news publication. I want to talk to you about the time we're in now, where there's so much racial injustice, where there's so much of people being left out and not included, where there's so much work being done to take the rights from people to vote. I want to talk to you today about the role you have in bringing justice to a nation. I want to talk to you today about what is it you're going to do day in and day out, as our honorary doctorate candidate said to you, about the issue of hunger and need in this community. I want to talk to you today about what is going to be your legacy. How will people remember your name? A man within 8 minutes and 46 seconds by the name of George Floyd lost his life. 8 minutes and 46 seconds, a man named that no one knew, a face that no one had ever seen, has changed the pace of a nation's understanding of what racial injustice is. A man that you would have never stopped on the street to talk to has now been known across the world. He motivated young and old, black and white and brown, those who were educated and those who were not, to stand up and speak out against injustice. Because in 8 minutes and 46 seconds, his life ended. So the challenge I give to you all today, what will be the legacy of your life journey? What will it be that will have you say, today is not today I'm going to permit anyone to be treated unfair? What will you do on the day when someone says, I don't want anyone black or brown in the room because they shouldn't be there? Will you be the voice that say that we live in a world that should be inclusive of all people from all walks of life? Will you be the one that says when someone says because someone has an alternative lifestyle, they shouldn't be respected? Will you be the one that will stand up and say every human being deserves to be respected and treated with dignity? Will you be the ones that say to anyone who says that I can't educate her or him because they're black and brown? Will you be the one that will take off your jackets and say, let me tutor them so they can have an opportunity just like I? Will you be the ones and leave a legacy across this community, across this state, and across this world of lifting ourselves out of where we are to where we need to go? Are you going to have the courage to say that enough is enough? Are you going to be the ones that say that I, like anyone else, wants an opportunity in life to be able to financially care for me and my family? Are you going to be the one to say, even though I have earned a degree and have the ability to do it, others should have that right too? I have a known friend, a great musician, by the name of the late James Brown. I know some of you may not have listened to his music. It was before your time. But I want you to YouTube him when you get home. James Brown did a song, and it was entitled, I Don't Want Nobody to Give Me Nothing. I'll Get It Myself. I want you all to be the generation and the class that will add a new lyric to James Brown's song. I don't want nobody to give me nothing. I'll get it myself. I want you to add the lyrics to James Brown's song. I don't want you to get in the way of anybody being able to get it themselves. I want you to be the ones to say that I am not going to be okay because I'm a male believing that a woman can't be the CEO or the mayor or the governor or the vice president or the president of the United States of America because you're the one that's working on the campaign. I want you to be the ones that say, I'm tired of this old position of leadership. Only for some, I'm going to spread my wings and bring all of the people, not just into the frickin' tent, but at the table to make decisions and change lives every day. I want you to write the new lyrics to James Brown's song to remind people that who are you to stand in the judgment about what people can't have? Time is long overdue. We need to be able now, this very moment, to rid this community, this nation, and this world of poverty and despair. The time is now to rid ourselves of the belief that racial injustice is okay for some and not for others. The time is now for us to free ourselves of the belief that some people should and others never can. The time is now for us to realize that we are more than our brother's keeper. We are our sister's keeper and the keeper of hope for future generations. And you are that generation that must not tap us on the shoulder. Those of us that are AARP members that are so used to it being one way. You are the ones that have the legacy to tap us on our shoulder and say there's a new day and a new time. You are the ones that will be restless. You are the ones that should have a loud voice. It's no longer okay for young children in this community to go hungry at night. It's no longer okay for families to have to sleep in a car because they've been evicted. It's not okay. It's no longer okay because of the color of my skin, I should be judged about whether I can get a loan to buy a house, to buy a car, educate my children, start a business. The time is now for it to change. And you are the generation that must have the courage to stand up and say, now is the time. If someone should ask you, why do you have so much energy? Why are you driving this issue so? Tell them at your commencement, a woman told you, you were rewriting James Brown's song. I don't want nobody to give me nothing. Open up the door, I'll get it myself. You're writing the other lyrics. Not only am I rewriting it, I'm going to open all of the doors for all of those who need to get it themselves. You are the generations when someone says, what are you doing this weekend? I'm marching in the streets of Milwaukee, Mequon, and on and on and on, because I'm not going to be okay with anyone being denied the right to vote because you're rewriting the song that James Brown started. You are the ones that should stand up every day and say, it is not okay for us to still be talking about racial injustice. What are we doing about it? You are the ones that must say that police brutality is not fair for anyone. And it's certainly not fair for a man to lose his life in 8 minutes and 46 seconds. You are the ones to rewrite the lyrics. You are the ones we are counting on to brand a new brand for us as a nation. You are the ones that I'm asking to have the courage to stand up, be the voice that others cannot, don't have the opportunity to have. You be the ones that have the strong backs to keep them straight when things are difficult. You are the ones that have to raise your fists and say, no, that's not the way it should be. And you are the ones that should leave a legacy for longer, our prayer is, than 8 minutes and 46 seconds. Let your life be a legacy for power, for change, for dignity, and respect. Thank you for the opportunity of being with you today.
Thank you, Ms. Sias, for your service to Cardinal Stritch University, to our community, and for your inspirational words today. We'll now present the 2021 candidates for degrees and class of 2020 graduates. Please note that your commencement program lists in alphabetical order the names of all the candidates eligible to receive degrees and those who have successfully completed degree requirements in 2020. However, the candidates and graduates participating in today's ceremony have elected to sit with classmates of their choosing. Interim President Scholes, upon the recommendation of the faculty and the approval of the Board of Trustees, I have the honor of presenting candidates and graduates for the following degrees: Associate of Arts, Associate of Science, Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Fine Arts, Bachelor of Science. Dr. Kate Might, Dean of the College of Undergraduate Studies, and Dr. Carl Mueller, Associate Dean of the College of Undergraduate Studies, will announce the names and honors of each degree candidate or graduate as they cross the stage. The candidates and graduates will receive special Cardinal Stritch University alumni pins that were blessed at yesterday's commencement mass. The pins are a ceremonial recognition of their Stritch degree. Candidates and graduates, please proceed to the stage as directed by the ushers and bring your name cards with you. Dr. Mary Kellner and Mr. Gerard Randall, co-chairs of the Stritch Board of Trustees, will greet you as you pick up your diploma.
Micaela Fonseca.
Emily Chaplesky.
She's on the stage.
Katrina Herman, summa cum laude.
Paola Cerato.
Azucena Reyes, cum laude. Lucy Hartnell,
Pearl,
summa cum laude.
Sorry. Pearl Goodwin.
Nevada Reed.
Estrella Luciano Moreno, cum laude.
Andrew Scholz, magna cum laude.
Leslie Padilla, summa cum laude.
Sarah Berger.
Christine Stark, magna cum laude.
Courtney King.
Jessica Casares, cum laude.
Melanie Weaver.
Blanca Perez, cum laude.
Ilse Merlin Tiburcio, magna cum laude.
Alexis Carniero.
Danielle Deal, magna cum laude.
Juan Sandoval.
Britannia Huesca.
Karina Ugarte.
Jose Lizarraga Mazaba, magna cum laude.
Veronica Alanis.
Scott Schlunner, magna cum laude.
Nakia McGee.
Michael Hocker.
Miriam Alanis Moreno, cum laude.
Timothy Sampson, summa cum laude.
Leslie Morales, cum laude.
Sonia Vladas Lopez.
Yamilet Lopez.
Kiki Thompson, summa cum laude.
Yet Lanezi Ortega, magna cum laude.
Gloria Shaw.
Noelia Martinez, cum laude.
Diana Williams.
Maria Federico.
Abigail Alcock, summa cum laude.
Beatrice Reyes.
Madeline Stevens, summa cum laude.
Jennifer Nagel, summa cum laude.
Chelsea Kelly, cum laude.
Nicole Greenwood, summa cum laude.
Asiya Trimari.
Maria Amaneros.
Lara Gomkin, cum laude.
Olympia Garcia.
Angela Elias, summa cum laude.
Jacqueline Wilhelm, summa cum laude.
Kara Shimko, magna cum laude.
Mia Badar, summa cum laude.
Iago Pelter de Quiros, academic distinction.
Marisol Cranky, summa cum laude.
Eduardo Santana, summa cum laude.
Lauren Stack, summa cum laude.
Christopher Winters.
Fatima Sino, summa cum laude.
Jayla Coates.
Samantha Beltran.
Sarah Smith.
Sydney Hero, summa cum laude.
Jocelyn Reed, cum laude.
Asia Martinez.
Katra Sustecha Castro, magna cum laude.
Pedro Hernandez Murillo.
Ashley Reynolds, academic distinction.
Jonisa Chisholm.
Lonnie Slocum, cum laude.
Hannah Shine, magna cum laude.
Nicholas Rodinelli, summa cum laude.
Jenna Brown, summa cum laude.
Amber Sumter, magna cum laude.
Catherine Formella, cum laude.
Shelby Zunker, magna cum laude.
Luz Pacheco Rodriguez.
Quentin Joyner.
Alejandro Barroso, cum laude.
Hariat Falahi.
Edith Hernandez Caballero.
Nicole Marquardt, magna cum laude.
Caitlin Bailey, summa cum laude.
Andrew Mork, academic distinction.
Ebeth Montez, magna cum laude.
Kelsey Malik, magna cum laude.
Aviana Yanke, summa cum laude.
Jayla Harris.
Rodney Parks.
Melissa Johnson.
Ashley Friday.
Denise Guzman.
Miles Jett, academic distinction.
Andrew Riggle.
Ashley Biscobing.
Siobhan Clark.
Emma Barbian, summa cum laude.
Elwin Fonseca.
Alexis Wilson.
Kung Tang.
Dulce Gutierrez.
Kathleen Carrasquillo.
Adriana Alonso Morales.
Nicolo Rossi, summa cum laude.
Frida Aguilar Salas.
Mayel Gaze Shomek, summa cum laude.
Fatima Barajas, magna cum laude.
Sebastian Aragara Balbontin.
Giovanni Nuno Rodriguez, cum laude.
Javier Apelanis, cum laude.
Aaron Mould.
Francesco Tacconi, academic distinction.
Abigail Michalski.
Jezariah Burton.
Zuleika Mohammed.
Marie Polk.
Juan Sariano, cum laude.
Abdul Rafe Munarudin.
Nicola Worley, magna cum laude.
Diego Romero.
Tiffany Webb.
Jamarquan Houston, cum laude.
Albert Moore Jr., academic distinction.
Jacqueline Tavares Vera.
Alexandra Taylor.
Jose Shamba.
Lisa Keller, summa cum laude. Kimberly Tate, magna cum laude.
Will all our candidates and graduates please rise? By the authority invested in and delegated to me by the Cardinal Stritch University Board of Trustees, I confer upon you the degrees for which you have qualified, along with all the rights, privileges, and distinctions to which they entitle you. As is the custom at commencement, I ask you now to move the tassels on your caps from right to left as a sign of your transition from candidate to graduate. Thank you. Please be seated. Congratulations, graduates. As the newest alumni of Cardinal Stritch University, you join an elite group of more than 38,000 women and men who have been educated in the Catholic Franciscan liberal arts tradition. We can attest that there are great things in store for each and every one of you, and your Stritch family is excited for your next chapter. And while it may feel as though you are leaving Stritch, you really aren't, because you take with you all of your fellow students, faculty, staff, and alumni. We will always be there with you and for you as you continue your journey. Now please rise for the concluding prayer offered by Professor Marilyn Jones, Chair of the Humanities Department and recipient of the 2020 Stritch Presidential Award for Civic Action and Engagement. Upon conclusion of the benediction, we request that guests and graduates remain seated until after the recessional, which is an integral part of the ceremony. Dr. Meir will lead the platform party recessional following the prayer. Professor Jones.
May God's blessing follow you all as you find new journeys to travel. May you walk safely along the pathways of your dreams and aspirations. May God's gentle hand guide the decisions you will make and the passions you will follow. May your hearts and minds always reflect God's love and truth. And may hope and joy be a light within you that you carry into each new day. Amen.